some of you might remember watching the Sydney Olympics. Some of you might even remember watching the rowing, in which case you probably remember watching Redgrave and Pinson, where Redgrave got his fifth consecutive gold medal. I wasn't in that one. I was in the eighth race the following day. And I want to talk a bit about the morning in the final, but also about the 2 years leading up to that point. We knew what was most important. We knew what was most important, and you know, we had agreed that we wanted to win. Therefore, every single conversation, every discussion, every decision that we made, every action that we took had to be aligned to helping us win. Now, we couldn't control whether we won, because we had no control over how fast the Russians, the Dutch, the Germans, or anyone else were going to hit. All we could do was control how fast we went.
In terms of how do we bring this to life, how do you apply this? In sports psychology, performance and its bedfellow, the process that leads to your performance, is kind of the king and queen of everything that we would do in sport and leadership development, sports psychology, leadership development. The more that we can focus on how we perform, what we're doing, the more likely we are to shift our mindset from trying to chase results, which can create greater levels of anxiety and uncertainty, and more to this sense of actually, if I just improve my performance, the results will come to me, which is a far more nurturing kind of a mindset and approach.
As an athlete, to march the opening ceremony is, it's an amazing moment. With another 204 countries, you're gonna kind of go into the stadium, you go down the tunnel to get onto the track, and you can see the kind of the bright lights at the end of the tunnel, the energy, you can feel the energy coming down the tunnel towards you. You know that as you step out, you'll have your jacket, your shirt, whatever, with your national flag, the Olympic rings. You know that at that moment, you're representing your country's Olympic Games. It's an incredible moment. And I've got one photo of us at the opening ceremony in Sydney. We decided not to go to the opening ceremony, actually. We thought that if we went, we'd be out of the village for 6 hours, we'd be on our feet for 4 hours, we'd miss a meal, we'd get to bed late. And we just didn't think that it would make the boat go faster. I'll show you the race and you can see how it worked out. And you might enjoy the kind of classic impartial BBC commentary that goes along with it.
They're going to run out of space, you're going to run out of water, because on Lake Penrith, the British boys are holding them up. 150 metres remain, and Australia continue to push back. But have we got enough now with 100 metres? 1912 in Stockholm was the last time we won. They're winding it up now. The Australians are coming back. It's 50 metres to the line, but we're going to do it. We're going to hold on. Go, boys. Go, boys. Here come the Australians. But it is gold. Gold for Great Britain. Olympic champions. Olympic champions here on Lake Penrith.